Hey up everyone, Magpie Gaming here. I hope you're all doing well. Apologies to start with if you hear any kind of weird sounds in the background. It's extremely noisy around where I'm living currently today. There's a lot of construction work going on just near me and it's very windy as well. So apologies if any of that gets picked up on mic. So anyway, back to the video. We've got some changes to discuss with Escape from Tarkov. There has been some buffs to the AK platform and indeed there's been quite a few made. Now I can't find a link anywhere to the Reddit post that actually lists these buffs, but you're just gonna have to take my word for it basically. But there's been a lot of ergonomic buffs to the platform and it looks as though they're trying to make the AK platform a little bit more viable. And I've got to say that personally I'm still using AKs. I have access to every weapon in the game now, but I'm still using the good old AK. I just find it a very, very trustworthy and reliable platform. I know a lot of people say that they don't like the recoil of the guns, etc., but if you do a little bit of tweaking you can get that down to a manageable level. And quite honestly, I kind of force myself to play with the AK, and if I can control the recoil on those weapons then I can control it on most weapons within the game, so it's kind of a training myself sort of exercise. But yeah, they've made quite a few changes to the platform. If I can find those changes I will of course link it in the description down below, but they have definitely done a little bit of work on it to tweak it and make it a little bit more viable. Now if I can't find the link to the Reddit post that lists all these changes, I will put a link to OnePeg's video where he actually has them in the corner of his screen, but he hasn't linked them in the description, but I will put a link to that so that you can quickly go through them. There's not many great, you know, there's not like huge changes, it's just little tweaks here and there to make those guns a little bit more viable. The next bit is the changes to the Bitcoin farm. There's been numerous changes being made to these. Now the construction requirements and costs have gone up. Quite why they've done this, I just do not know. It doesn't make sense to me. Now if you haven't up to now got your Bitcoin farm up and running, it's now going to be a lot harder for you to do that. It now takes a lot longer for us to farm Bitcoins as well. Now if you didn't know, the Bitcoin price within Escape from Tarkov is linked to the real world Bitcoin value. So in the real world, as it goes up, which it has recently, it's hit a big boom in the last couple of months, the price of it to sell it to therapist in the game actually goes up as well. And it got very, very close to 800,000 rubles yesterday per Bitcoin, which is unbelievable. Now I remember in the previous wipes it sort of fluctuated anywhere from 100 grand to up to 160 grand. If you got 160 grand for a Bitcoin you were laughing, but we are now looking at prices well above 500,000 rubles predominantly since this wipe occurred. So it seems as though Battlestate haven't really enjoyed this. You know, people are making too much money, so they're trying to make it now harder for us to make this money, which it just doesn't make sense. If you create an economy in a game that mimics a real life economy, if the real life economy goes wild, your economy in the game is going to go wild also. Allow it to do that. Let us enjoy it. Let us have all that money. It's not going to last forever. Bitcoin will crash eventually. It often does. Historically it does. So the prices will go down, but you know, let us enjoy it. They're just making it harder for what seems no real reason at all. Next one is the solar power farm that you can fix onto your hideout. This reduces your fuel consumption cost by a massive 50%. They've increased the costs of that. You now need more military power filters for that. It's gone up from 8 to 10. You need more military cables. It's gone up from 8 to 10. You need 50,000 euros now to start that up. Plus you need the 4 phased arrays, which are currently going for around 2 million on the market. It's crazy prices, it really is. Now as I say, if you have a Bitcoin farm up and running, you're in the money, you're okay, you'll be all right, it's fine, it doesn't matter. If you haven't got that Bitcoin farm up and running, I don't know how you're really making a lot of money in this game right now, not passively anyway. You're going to have to be actively going into raids and pulling gear out and selling it, because it's just, I don't know, why are they making it so hard? It just doesn't make sense to me. You want this economy to be living and breathing, yet you're constantly tweaking and changing it. It just doesn't sit right with me at the moment. Allow people to enjoy all that money. So people have got mega money and they can go to the flea market and buy all of the greatest gear. So what? That's part and parcel of the game. You wanted Battlestate, you wanted this live economy. Allow it to live and breathe. Stop stifling it all the time. But anyway, that's my 2 pence worth on this issue. So let me know in the comment section down below what you think about the changes. As I say, if I can link those changes, I will do. But yeah, good changes to the AK platform. It's about time that platform got a little bit of love in, and it's had plenty just recently. But I have to give a thumbs down to the Bitcoin farm changes and the solar power farm changes. It doesn't make sense to me. But there you go, that's just me. So as always, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for watching and listening. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Stay safe, and I will catch you in the next one. Take care.